Hello friends, I'm sure in your day-to-day life, every second day you go out for shopping, isn't it? It is needless to say that today's world lives in fast-forward motion where we want everything under one roof. So what can be a better option than a retail store which provides you everything under one roof? Obviously, the answer will be yes. But friends, have you ever thought of the study of this retail sector? If no, then you are on the right track. So friends, welcome to Corporate Bridge training program on financial modeling of retail sector. I know you are very curious to know the meaning of the word retail. Retail is the sale of goods to end users, not for resale, but for use and consumption by the purchaser. The retail transaction, that is when we buy something from the store, is at the end of the supply chain. Manufacturers sell large quantities of products to retailers, and retailers attempt to sell those same quantities of products to consumers. So, what is the meaning of the retail sector? The retail sector includes all the shops that sells goods to the ultimate customer who buys them for personal use. It consists of all kinds of shops from small groceries to supermarket chains and large department stores. So, which products are sold in retail shops or the supermarkets? The products includes soft goods or consumables like clothing, other fabrics, footwear, cosmetics, medicines, and stationery. Durable goods like automobiles, appliances, electronics, furniture, sporting goods, etc. Food products. Arts like contemporary art galleries, bookstores, handicrafts, musical instruments, gift shops. Now let's do the industry analysis of this particular sector. Today, retailing is seen as an important sector of an economy in terms of its contribution to GDP and share in the total employment. So, if we see, the retail outlets vary from small family-run stores to globally established giants like Walmart. The industry alone also covers a wide range of sectors from general products such as food and clothing to specialist goods such as sports and equipment accessories. Also, the retail industry gets affected by interest rates. Also, it gets influenced by the consumer confidence in products and personal income of the consumers. So what most of the companies do is they try to promote their products as much as possible in order to gain the confidence of consumers. And with unique product ideas, they focus on their customer service to attract the revenue. So let's have a look at the retail industry at global level. It is needless to say that retail industry has its footprints all over the world. US being the superpower in retailing has maintained its dominance in global retailing on the 2014 list of all world's largest US retail chains. Also, retail sector along with contribution to GDP employs high number of people in America. If we see in America, about 1 out of 10 workers work in the retail industry. The same is the case in the emerging nations like China, India, Mexico, and Brazil. They are showing huge progress in terms of this retail sector. So, who are the top global retailers? Obviously, Walmart, Tesco, Costco Wholesale, Carrefour, and Kroger. So, basically, these are the top 5 companies at the global level. Now we will have a look on retail industry in India. Retail is the booming sector of India at present times, and it accounts for 14 to 15% of its GDP. So the Indian retail market is estimated to be $500 billion, and it is the one of the fastest growing retail markets and also employs large amount of people in India. Now let's see the key drivers which are contributing towards the betterment of retail industry in India. Infrastructure. Development of infrastructure and establishment of connectivity has been the important key driver in retail industry. Secondly, education. Literacy has led to the creation of smart customers, which has resulted in increasing the value of the retail sector. Of course, the increased industrialization process in terms of country's development, as it now exports various industrial products to the foreign countries. Communication. Through communication, the electronic media has also contributed in the success of retail industry. Media. Again, it is very important from the point of view of the advertisements, promotions of the products. The more it does the promotions, the more people are attracted towards the company's products. Changing attitude and modern thinking of country folks has also played a major role in the betterment of retail industry. Now, let's do this SWOT analysis of Indian retail sector. Strength. Purchasing power. Purchasing power of middle class is increasing, through which spendings are also increasing. Population demographics. India's working population is also increasing day by day. People are happy with the services provided under one roof, so obviously shopping convenience is one of the strength of the retail industry. Changing consumer habits and lifestyles. Weaknesses, political uncertainty and regulatory requirements. As we know, right from the announcement of FDI, it has stirred the political pot in India. It has been the very hot topic. Poor infrastructure and supply chain management. Still, in some of the areas, the infrastructure is not developed that much, where it is to be focused on. Now, let's look at the opportunities where the industry can enter into. Is innovation. Companies can focus on innovation and research and development methodologies through the use of technologies. Also, it can adopt for digital strategy in terms of e-commerce, e-services and many other things. They can go for customer-centric approach, and if possible, the changing regulatory scenario can also be a good opportunity. Threats. Again, retail company needs a large availability of land and real estate. So obviously getting this is a big question, and that too at feasible rates. Secondly, management of human capital, as the attrition rate in terms of retail industry is very high. So this is what was the SWOT analysis of retail sector. Here we can see the major players in Indian retail sector, like the list is taken from moneycontrol.com. We have Shoppers Stop, Future Retail, Keval Kiran, Future Life, Pantaloons Fash, V-Mart Retail, Prozone Capital and so on. So friends, the company that we have selected for the study of the sector is Shoppers Stop. So we will do the financial modeling and valuation of Shoppers Stop Limited. So let's have a look at the company profile of Shoppers Stop. Shoppers Stop is an Indian department store chain promoted by the K. Raheja Corporation Group, and it was started in the year 1991. It is spread across 32 cities in India and it has over and above 65 stores. It retails the various products including ladies' watches, men's watches, artificial jewelry, handbags, fragrances, footwears, home furnishing and decor products.